Tonight on Top Gear, we try to destroy a BMW. Hammond buys the wrong car, and May gets lost.
Vehicles left running were Toyota trucks. Because of this, the producers gave us 1,500 quid to go out and buy four-wheel drive Toyotas. We were told only to meet at the lighthouse.
Hatteras Island is a remote island known only for its rugged locals, lighthouse, and small piping floaters, which I greatly enjoy shooting. And I was first to arrive.
Right. This is a 1992 Toyota pickup truck. Got 108,000 miles on it. Massive inline four power, putting out 106 brake horsepower. Four-wheel drive, massive oversized tires for off-road. We have a bed for cargo. Golly, he's bought a Land Cruiser.
We Land Cruiser.
He bought a Land Cruiser.
Have you seen Jeremy?
Tank.
What you did wrong was that the Australians have been using these for 45 years. It's pretty much an exclusive vehicle, and the Australians know something about emus.
This has got to weigh 1,000 pounds more than mine.
It weighs 1,500.
Oh my god.
But how many liters do you have?
2.4.
Haha, 4.2. How many cylinders?
4.
Ah, 6.
Several hours later, Hammond arrives.
Here's Hammond. What bought the wrong car?
What happened?
It was the Toyota challenge.
It's definitely a Toyota.
It's a Toyota, isn't it?
You did see what clearly. Toyota.
What type of Toyota is that?
Pickup.
Uh-huh. What year?
84.
Really,
right,
really. And they just called it the pickup, did they?
Really, yeah. Did they call it the Toyota pickup, or was it the Nissan pickup? Hammond, what were you thinking?
It was cheap.
How much did you pay for it?
$400.
It's a lovely Toyota.
It is a great Toyota. Man, it even has Toyota seats in it. That's amazing. Toyota steering wheel.
But that's an interesting point about my vehicle, is that if you come over here, previous owner have taken the liberty of replacing the original rubber Spartan Toyota interior for quite lovely Sevi one, which was made by the Americans, which means it's made to accommodate a wider bottom than the British people.
I don't know what you're talking about. I have way better seats than you. Previous owner of this vehicle put seat covers on it. Original. Stock seats, brand new.
And can they recline?
Yes.
All right, what do you think they're gonna have us do?
Can we get the challenge? Being in the Taliban requires both speed and agility, both of which will be tested in an off-road driving challenge. Meet at the fish cleaning tables for the challenge.
You know, that didn't quite work for me.
I think I am perfectly
power
set up.
Power steering is going to be a very difficult problem.
You don't have power steering?
Yeah. Beach, no power steering. Yeah.
Oh, let's go.
Well, let's go.
Keep rolling.
It was only a short drive to the fish cleaning tables. Somehow, May managed to get lost. And there he is now. As I was least hungover from the night before at Peter's, I went first.
tires. Come on. Bogging in third. My foot is to the floor, going nowhere. Not accelerating. Now the torque band on these engines, it's very low in terms of most modern engines. It's only at about 3,000 RPMs, but still we're only putting out 134 torques, which is not much for this vehicle. It doesn't weigh much, but still takes a long time to get someplace. That's why they say they're so reliable. So slow. 35 on this back road. I don't know how fast James is going, but must be able to beat him. Whoa! Up here on the turnaround, I think James did this in three. I think I can swing the whole thing at once.
Sadly, I was wrong. My turnaround wasn't quick enough.
Ah!
Listen to those 15-year-old TV pop.
Engine still hasn't come up to temp. This Toyota's run very cold-blooded. I'm maybe on the sea of cold. I don't know how good this is, but we do have heat on this frigid winter day.
My run was coming together like nerds to a start.
Shift and make power through these intense sections. But in most cars, I'd be downshifting. James, I know, only has a 4-speed. I'm wondering how ratio he's set up. He might need to. I don't know how he's making power through here. So he does have more torque. Final stretch. Whoa. Smooths out here at the end. I can feel that 107 horsepower really pulling me through to the end. And there it is.